And I made a mention of one of these sins that this flesh commits. And that was taking mick and making fun out of the people. And I made a mention that this is a sin that we all commit to some extent. Our elders commit this sin, and even our youngsters at the age of 8 and 9 commit this sin. Majority of the sins are committed by this piece of flesh. And moving on to a sin that nearly everybody commits, illa man asima rabbuk. The young, the old, the small, the big, the learned, the non-learned, the male, the female, everyone to some extent or another, illa man asima rabbuk, except those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved, everyone to some extent commit this sin. And yet again, it is the sin of this tongue. And this sin is called backbiting, talking evil about somebody. And we commit this sin day and night without even realizing, without even considering it a sin. Even in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we come to the masjid and we are waiting for salah, instead of making zikr, instead of remembering the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, instead of reciting the Quran, instead of sending salutations on Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sending durood upon our beloved Nabi, we will sit against the radiators, and there you will find that we are talking and we are backbiting somebody, we are talking evil about somebody. Even in the days of Hajj, in the holy cities of Makkah al-Mukarramah and Madinah al-Munawwara, even in the state of Ihram, when we are wearing the pure white sheets, you will find that we are having a go at some Saudi official or our group leader. We commit this sin day in, day out. And on top of this, which is even worse, is that we justify our ghibah. We justify this sin that we commit by saying that we are speaking the truth. What we are saying is exactly in the person that whom we are talking about. And we don't just say it behind his back. We can confront him with this sin. We can say it on his face. And many a time we have said it on his face. This is exactly what ghibat is. This is exactly what this sin is. Whether you say it on his face or whether you say it behind his back, it is called ghibat. Especially, it is called ghibat. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once asked the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, O my Sahaba, atadruna mal ghibat? Oh my Sahaba, do you know what ghibat is? Do you know what backbiting is? The Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een replied, Ki Allah wa Rasuluhu ahda. That Allah and His Messenger Muhammad Rasulullah salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi no bahs. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Zikruka akhaka bima yakrah. To make a mention of your brother in a manner which displeases him, to say something about your brother which your brother dislikes, this is ghibah. Whether you say it in front of his face or whether you say it when he's not there, in his absence, behind his back, if it is something that if your brother was to come to know of this and he would dislike this, then this is what ghibah is. The Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu majma'in asked, يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كأرأيت إن كان في أخي ما أقول. If what I'm saying with regards to my brother, the thing I have mentioned with regards to my brother, if this thing is inside my brother, this sifat that I have mentioned, my brother has this inside him, will it still be classed as ghibat? نبي كريم صلى الله عليه وسلم replied, كإن كان فيه ما تقول فقد اضطبته. وَإِنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ فِيهِ مَا تَقُولُ فَكَدْ بَهَتَّ. That if this thing that you have mentioned with regards to your brother, if this thing is inside your brother, then this is exactly what ghibat is. And if this thing is not inside your brother, and you have said something with regards to your brother, which your brother is pure of, then you have committed a sin even bigger than ghibah, then you have committed the sin of buhtan, which is far greater than the sin of ghibah. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam disliked this sin so much that on one occasion Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was on a journey with the Azwaj Mutahharat, with the wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with our mothers. Now Hazrat Safiya radiallahu ta'ala anha's camel fell sick, and our mother Hazrat Zainab radiallahu ta'ala anha had a spare camel, had an extra one. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Sayyidina Zainab, "A'tiha ba'ira," that the spare camel you have, give it to Hazrat Safiya radiallahu ta'ala anha. Now our mother Hazrat Safiya radiallahu ta'ala anha was of Jewish origin, from the progeny of the great prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sayyidina Musa and Sayyidina Harun alayhim as-salam. When Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Hazrat Zainab to give her this camel, she replied, "O Messenger of Allah, ana u'ti tilka al-yahudiyya? Shall I give it to that Yahudiyya?" Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam disliked this comment of hers so much. Though in reality, our mother Hazrat Safiya, this was her origin. Our Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam disliked this remark so much that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stopped speaking to our mother Hazrat Zainab radiallahu ta'ala anha for over 2 months. He did not speak to her in the month of Zilhijjah. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not speak to her in the month of Muharram. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not speak to her in some days of Safar. And why not? Because he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the one that has said, "Inna min arda al-riba al-istitalata fi irdi al-muslim bi-ghayri haqq." We know how big of a sin taking and giving interest is. We know that one penny that a person gives in interest, or one penny he receives as interest, this is worse than committing adultery with one's mother. Not once, not 10, 36 times. 36 times a person commits adultery with his mother. Put this sin in one part of the balance, and one penny of interest in the other part of balance, than this one penny of interest that a person has given or taken is worse than sin, worse than this, the sin of adultery with your mother 36 times. It is such a sin that the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, فَأْذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ, Allah and His Messenger has declared war with this person. And there are very few sins regarding which Allah and His Messenger Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi has declared war. Now Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, emphasizing how big this sin of ghibat is, has said, "Inna min arda al-riba al-istitalata fi irdi al-muslim baghayri haq," that one of the biggest types of sood, that one of the biggest types of riba, is this sin of backbiting, is to say something about your brother which he may dislike.